Michelle
from Yoga Shack in Bethpage, New York.
Welcome to
your quick fix.
Hey guys, it's Michelle. We're here to break down Malasana or Garland pose, which is really just a fancy word for squat. So I have a block here. If you have a block at home, they're great, especially if you're not that open in the hips or if your heels don't come straight down. So I'll show you with and without the block. You'll essentially bring your feet about outer hip distance apart. If you were at the top of your mat, your feet would probably be at the very edges of your mat. So that's just a template. Some people need a more narrow stance, some people need even wider, okay? Toes are slightly pointing outward, and then you begin to drop down. So making sure that your heels are on the floor just makes it a little bit easier to stay in. You bring your hands to heart center, and when you do that, you think of pushing your elbow gently into the inner part of the knee. So I hate calling it the knee because you don't want to push the knees out, but it's, you know, like the fleshy part. It's really just the inner leg, right? On both sides. And then you push your palms against one another. And then as you push your legs out with your elbows, you're pushing back on your elbows with your legs so that there's resistance in the inner thighs, the inner groin, and the arms. Right? Think of pushing your thumbs into your chest and your chest into your thumbs so you're sitting up nice and tall. Now, you can adjust the feet wider and more narrow. And if you need a block, right? You can literally take this block and boom, sit right on the block, right? And you're still getting the benefit because you're still pushing in on the arms and pushing out on the legs and you're still getting that resistance there, right? But if you don't need the block, you'll ditch it and you'll hang in your squat. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope it was helpful. Please subscribe and we'll see you soon.